Hello friends, we are going to discuss today about job selection for method study. The outcome of the session will be students will be able to understand factors for selection of job during method study. The content is how to select a job for method study and what are the factors affecting the selection. Those are falling into three categories called as economic, technical and human factors. How to select a job for method study? Well, all of us know what is method study. Method study is to find out an alternate, a better method for doing any activity. And then practically any activity or job can be selected for improvement. You can go to the shop, you can go to any service station and choose any job randomly for the improvement. But attempt should be made to select the job which are important from economic, important from productivity point of view, which are unpopular amongst employees or are considered to be dirty. Generally, employees don't like such types of jobs. And by improving such jobs, the workers should earn goodwill as well as the goodwill from the management and goodwill from amongst all other colleagues, which will help for the other studies in the future also. How to select a job for method study? So there are considerations which are given. The following factors play a very important role on the various considerations: economic considerations, technical considerations and human factor. We'll discuss one by one. What are the economical considerations? Economical considerations are, once we carry out a method study, the benefits arising out of that method study should be repetitive in nature, which will give better profits for the organization. The saving arising out of this particular method study should be continuously for a reasonable amount of time. As a result of that, it is obvious that jobs of repetitive nature must be considered as against project type job. Project type jobs are only one time jobs. If we carry out a method study and the job is not repeating, the entire method study may not have any value addition in the future course of time. Priority should be given to those jobs having the bottleneck in the production line. Generally, if you take the production line, there is bottleneck observed in some of the area. The simple way to identify bottleneck is just take a round and there will be some jobs waiting on some machine. You will find lot of WIP inventory on a particular machine. That means that appears to be bottleneck in the production line. As a result of that, if you carry out method study on the bottlenecking, naturally it will improve the productivity, it will improve the production flow, and it will also remove the bottleneck of the entire production line. There are some jobs where the labor content is very high. They are consuming more time as compared to machine time. In such cases, we must consider these jobs on a priority basis because labor content can be automated, labor content can be minimized, or in some cases, labor content can be replaced by a lower amount of skill also. There will be some areas or there will be some cases where the idleness of the machine or idleness of the person appear to be much more. That is, unnecessarily some machines are idle or sometimes some operators are idle. In such cases, the overheads will remain same. As a result of that, company may start losing money. So therefore, these areas also call for priority to select a job for method study. There is a large demand on the item, and as a result of that, we are unable to supply the item. As a result of that, these jobs should be taken more on a priority basis so that we can increase the production and increase the productivity by changing the method. And as a result of that, we can increase the production rate without adding much of the resources. There are jobs, now risk analysis is now part of the entire operations in the organization. There are jobs which are having a high risk. As a result of that, there are quite uncertainties, and therefore, those jobs which are having higher risk should also be considered for the priority for method study. There are some jobs where the wastage and the scrap or the reprocessing cost is very high. There are some jobs which are known that the material removal rate is very, very excessive. For example, we want to turn a diameter for a shaft from a larger diameter to very smaller diameter at the end. As a result of that, we are wasting both material as well as the machining cost. Therefore, high scrap is obvious. Such cases should be considered first for method study. There are situations where the company has to pay overtime to the operators. As a result of that, overtime payment becomes more. This mainly, the root cause of such cases will be mainly because of the higher production time or more waiting of the jobs. Those will be covered somewhere, either because of the higher labor content or because of the bottlenecking that may result into higher payment or overtime bills. Such jobs also should be considered on a priority basis. The next important factor is technical factors. The method study engineer must have necessary technical knowledge about the job to be studied. Only surface knowledge may not lead to right solution to real problem. Some of the considerations for this is technical capacity and capacity of a resource. For example, it is observed that a particular job is not giving repetitive capability, and then we decide to take the job for method study. But before that, we must analyze the machining process and the machining process capability, machine capability. Suppose machine capability is 10 microns, and then we are trying to go for a job which is having a machine capability, which requires a capability of 5 microns. In such cases, method study may not be of help. The entire exercise may go waste. Sometimes capacity of the job is also important. We plan for method study. When it goes for trial basis, then it is observed that this capacity of the resource is not sufficient for the particular job. As a result of that, we may fail into the method study before going to the final conclusions. Technical competency of the people. Some special jobs requires higher rate of skills, and those competencies, if not available in the company, may not call for selection of the job for method study. In that case, we need to seek expertise opinion, or we need to go for the outsourcing of the process. Technical setups. Sometimes setups are also causing a lot of issues, and unless we are satisfied with the technical setup capabilities, we should not go for the job for method study. Repair and maintenance jobs, where we are taking some jobs for repairs and maintenance. In such cases, repair maintenance capabilities also not observed. In that case, these jobs are also not calling for the selection of a job for method study. Metrological considerations, a very important but most of the times neglected area, is that we don't have the measuring capability of the particular dimension, and our metrological considerations are limited, and we come across this particular fact at the end of the operation. As a result of that, that may appear to be a bottleneck in the method study. The last factor is human factor. Even though we may have chosen technical factors as well as the economical factors are taking consideration in it, finally, it is the human who operates all these operations. As a result of that, human factors and human reactions are most important amongst the factors for method study. One of the commonly observed factor is that unnecessary fear about the method study, especially to the solutions like automation. Workers feel that if I go for an automated solution, I may lose my job, it may create unemployment, or it may create some other unrest in the company. It is always better to take first jobs which are considered dirty, unsafe, unpleasant, boring, or having higher stress. Workers are facing their stress levels very high. Workers see that the job is very unsafe. In such cases, if we choose those jobs, workers will be very happy, and they will definitely support and then welcome the jobs for method study, which will they feel that after doing the method study, their boring or their stress level has been reduced considerably. Economic considerations, where cooperation of the operator is much more. Human engineering, where the ergonomic of a machine or ergonomic of the entire setup is not correct. In that case, we must choose those areas on a top priority basis. Then jobs which lead to a higher level of material handling also can be considered into the human factors. Now, after considering all these, now think for that which are the possible measures to get cooperation from workers during method study. Method study needs cooperation from workers. Which are the possible measures? The first one is training, motivation, incentives, or all of the above. Think for this. Yes, you are right. All and all factors are important for the correct and for the good cooperation from the workers. It is the workers' cooperation which is more important. Without workers' cooperation and without human factor, we are unable to get the success. There are number of examples where technical and economical considerations are very strong, but human factors have a resistance. As a result of that, those method studies cannot be sustained. So thank you once again.